Okay, and welcome back. So if you've already seen part one, then good, carry on watching. If not, please go back and watch it. The link will be in the description. So once you've been printing for a while and you've earned a decent amount of money and you think you're ready to move on, what you're going to want to do is look at the printers. Now, if you get a gold printer, this will basically mean that people can raid you, which means your defenses need to be good, because if they raid you, it means they can destroy your stuff if they get into your base. So you're going to want to work on your defenses. So the first thing you want to do is, obviously I've made the base like this. Now this is the amount of props you want to have, this is how you want it to be. That's fine. But once you've done that, you also want an auto repair unit. This basically will mean that when your prop is damaged, this will automatically repair it up to a point. If it has to repair too much, too quickly, the temperature will increase, it will set on fire, and it will start damaging itself. So once you need to get one of them and put it relatively close to your props. In this base, it doesn't really matter, but if you're a really big base, you want to make sure that's nearish to the door. So once you've done that, you're good. Now, you're also going to want to get turrets. These will shoot your enemies during a raid. They won't shoot anyone if it's not during a raid, but they're handy for that. You want to push them so they're like that and they're pointing outside. Some bases have thick walls, so you have to point them out of windows and stuff like that, but in this base you can just do this. Oh, just like that. They're not that effective and they can be destroyed quite quickly, but they're good for delaying enemies so they can't just rush you straight away and gives you time to get back to your base and stuff like that. So you're going to push them out. These also need powering, so you're going to want to upgrade. If you're going to do raiding, you want to get a gold printer so you can earn more money. You're going to want to upgrade from a diesel to a uranium generator, which is what we'll do now. So a uranium generator looks like this. It costs more, but will output a lot more. So you see it says out of 30 there on the output. This is only out of 20. So we're going to want to go get fuel now, because everything's out of fuel. So we're going to walk out of here. Oh, hello, mate. And let's grab some diesel for the diesel one quickly, and then I'll show you where one of the uranium spawns is on this map. Uranium is a lot less common than the other fuel types, so you're going to want to look for the locations of that and just memorize them. One of them's quite easy on this map, just here. That's what uranium looks like, a little ball of green. You want to just pick that up the same way as the diesel and just bring it back to your base. Oh, try not to do that, and then bring it back. This will last a lot longer than the other fuels and will power a lot more things, but you still obviously need to refuel it from time to time. So now you can see everything's being powered. That's already maxed out. You see, that's why you need this, because that's now going to power your turrets and your auto repairs and stuff. So that's everything done. You're now in a good state to defend. This is what you need, the basics of what you need to defend. You also need to fight the players, and by that you need to make a spawn point, which is like this. You want to get instructions to make a spawn point. That means whenever you die, you're going to spawn here and be able to fight. You want to keep that outside of your base so you can fight people that are attacking your base. Okay, but this is what you need to defend against a raid. When you want to attack someone using the raid system, which is the only way you can, you also need a radar tower. This will allow you to scan people. So you'll need this, and you'll also need a gold printer or above. So either a gold, diamond, platinum, or nuclear. But for right now, you just want goals. That's the next level up. So once you have one of these, you can get two. But once you have one, that means you're raidable. So if my friend here wanted to raid me, he could, and I can now raid him if he has a gold printer. My radar is not yet charged. You see 0 out of 2 charges. And once that says 1 out of 2, I could potentially scan somebody. So the way you scan someone is you hold tab, and you see this menu here that shows you where the players are. You just click scan. You won't have these two buttons. You'll just click scan here. That will show you where the enemy printers are, and you can go and shoot their props and shoot their stuff and get XP. And they can do the same for you. But you only want to do this once you settle this up. If you do it before that point, they're going to easily get into your base, easily destroy your things. So you want to settle this up first, gives you a good point of defense before you move on to raiding. So this is your next step. I hope that's taught you everything you need to know for your next progression. There'll be following videos on what to do next. But this is basically your bog standard raiding basing setup, and this is what you want to aim for most scenarios. Thanks for watching, and goodbye.